Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today I'm here to update you with some informations regarding COVID-19. Our mind voice is right what? Yes, coronavirus is genetically modified virus. Why a plan for a bio-war? Did you know the Chinese New Year? At that time, all the Chinese come to their home country and after the celebration they went to their places. I hope you understood what I am thinking. Before going to the topic, if you are new to our channel, kindly subscribe. And you will get the daily morning videos. Okay, let's go to the topic. We are dividing this session into three. The part one. Here, today we are going to discuss the points that boost your mind that the coronavirus is a man-made virus. The genomic sequence of SARS-CoV-2 is suspiciously similar to that of a bat coronavirus, which is discovered by military laboratories in the 3rd Military Medical University and the Research Institute for Medicine of Nanjing Command. The receptor binding motif within the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2, which resembles that the SARS-CoV-2 from the 2003 epidemic in a suspicious manner. Genomic evidence suggests that the RBM has been genetically manipulated. In addition, a rare codon associated with this additional sequence suggests the strong possibility that this furin cleavage site is not the product of natural evolution and could have been inserted into the SARS-CoV-2 genome artificially by techniques other than the simple serial passage or multi-strain recombination events inside the co-infected tissue cultures or animals. The figure shows that the genomic sequence analysis reveals that the bat coronavirus ZC45 is the closest match to SARS coronavirus. The figure shows that the sequence alignment of the E protein from different beta coronaviruses demonstrate the E protein's permissiveness and tendencies towards the amino acid mutations. The figure shows that the structure of the SARS spike protein and how it binds to the HACE2 receptor. Three spike proteins, each consisting of a S1 half and a S2 half, form a trimer. The S2 halves, shades of blue, are responsible for trimer formation, while the S1 portion, shades of red, is responsible for binding HACE2, the dark gray. Now we are at the part 2. In the second part of this report, we describe a synthetic route of creating SARS coronavirus in a laboratory setting, possible scheme in designing the laboratory creation of the novel coronavirus. Once they have chosen a template virus, they would first need to engineer through molecular cloning the spike protein so that it can bind HACE2. Second, they would use molecular cloning to introduce a furin cleavage site at the S1-S2 junction of spike. Third, they would produce an ORF1B gene construct. The ORF1B gene encodes the polyprotein ORF1B, which is processed post-translationally to produce individual viral proteins. The RNA-dependent RNA polymerase, or RDRP, helicase, guanidine N7 methyl transferase, uridylate-specific endoribonuclease, and 2-O-methyl transferase. All of these proteins are a parts of the replication machinery of the virus. Among them, the RDRP protein is the most crucial one and is highly conserved among coronavirus. Importantly, the laboratory uses a PCR protocol which amplifies a particular fragment of the RDRP gene as their primary method to detect the presence of coronavirus in raw samples like bat, fecal, swabs or feces, etc. As a result of this practice, the Shai group has documented the sequence information of this short segment of RDRP for all coronaviruses that they have successfully detected and or collected. The postulated synthetic route for the creation of SARS coronavirus in this subsection, we describes in more details how each step could be carried out in a laboratory setting using available materials and routine molecular, cellular and virologic techniques. A diagram below this process is shown. We estimate that the whole process could be completed in approximately 6 months. Step 1. Engineering the RBM of the spike for HACE2 binding, 1.5 months. Step 2. Engineering a furin cleavage site at the S1 or S2 junction, 0.5 month. Step 3. Obtain an ORF1B gene that contains the sequence of the short RDRP segment from RABT-CoV-4991. 1 month, it can be carried out concurrently with step 1 and 2. And step 4, produce the designed viral genome using reverse genetics and recover live viruses, 1/2 month. And step 5, optimize the virus for fitness and improve its HACE2 binding affinity in vivo, that is 2.5 to... Let's see the part 3. Final remarks. Many questions remain unanswered about the origin of SARS-CoV virus 2. The prominent virologists have implicated that laboratory escape, but science proved it that genetic evidence within the spike gene of SARS-CoV virus 2 genome does exist and suggests that the SARS-CoV virus 2 genome should be a product of genetic manipulation. Let's see the logical evidence. China is the place where COVID originated, but at present, see the condition. The cases are very less. How many of you know that the virus is transmitted from human to human, not from the animals? The truth exists, all of us know. It's a plan for bio-war. And the scientists of China too know. But they become silent and the above information is shared by a Chinese virologist. Even she alert WHO and CDC, but they take it as a simple one. Li Men Yan. She too is a Chinese, but she followed her Hippocrates oath. That's ethics, and share this information to the people. And my question is, she alerted WHO, but they didn't take it as a serious one until it becomes a novel. So, whose fault? Comment your answer. Thank you. Have a nice day.